division could have absorbed that strike and stayed in the fight. A near-perfect land to get the knockout win here tonight. All right, here's Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop this contest at 3 minutes, 37 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout, Holly the Preacher's Daughter Holm.
Well, there she is. This arena belongs to her here tonight. Hard-pressed to find a knockout in the women's game as stunning as that.
I mean, she...
So here we go with round one. This is some old school matchmaking, right? Classic striker versus grappler matchup. And given what these fighters have said all week, you expect them to try to take a similar approach as they've taken in past fights.
Yes, the whole life has led to this, right? You don't change what works. The grappler understands that if she is able to get this fight to the ground, she is in her comfort zone. But for the striker, she has to understand as long as she is at distance, she has the advantage and she feels most comfortable.
Nice job by her to sort of shell up defensively here and prevent any of these shots from getting through.
She is taking no damage because she's so on point defensively. Left hand punch from the clinch.
Stuff the takedown, no problem. Effective punch there. Oh!
She is such a diverse striker that looks like landing and it looks like she's going to finish this fight. Because she had to get that takedown.
Oh, the right hand is there for her.
Beautiful head kick.
That's a pretty filthy combo. Nation there by Holm. 25 total strikes for Holly Holm. And she did not miss there. This could be the end.
She hurt her so bad with that big head kick. I don't know how she stands.
Try to establish that jab. So the fighters are in the clinch again, DC. I get tired just watching these situations.
It's exhausting. This is a position where you are constantly draining at the gas tank of your opponent.
We're under 2 minutes now to go round one. That shot is blocked by Hall. Entry here.
Nice single leg entry. Rotates ahead outside to a high clutch.
Less than a minute to go in the round. Back to her feet now. Good sign for her there. Vieta gets touched by that kick there. Some nice power there with the left hook upstairs.
Another clinch position.
Half guard position for her here, and if you're the bottom fighter, this is truly a case of pick your poison.
Yeah, you gotta pick your poison. And if you're on the bottom, you gotta be.
Round two coming up next. Stop. All right, so we will see another round here. Sat her opponent down there in that previous round with a punch.
Surprisingly, we are going forward because I thought it was over. I saw that punch land. We started to yell, we started to scream. We thought the fight was done. But we move forward.
You ready to fight? Ready. Good.
Pretty good right hand.
What a punt.
Well, there's a huge strike right there, DC.
Great shot.
The takedown shot there. How good is her takedown D? And they separate. Holm gets hit with a kick. Well, showing no signs of slowing down, 41 total strikes have connected for Holly Holm. Well, it's still connecting on a pretty good clip, DC. 45% accuracy thus far against Ketlin Vieta. Again, she slips off the center line, avoids the contact. Great head movement, really, from her the entire fight tonight.
Great head movement. You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Oh, straight right. Holm gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitancy whatsoever here in round two. She has clearly found her rhythm and range.
Straight punch land.
No! And just like that, the fight is over.
Oh, my goodness. What a fight.
Well, that was just a... absolutely flush on the land, and I'm not even sure her opponent saw it coming. So sometimes it's the strike you don't see coming that spells your fate, and ultimately it goes in the books as a big knockout win for her here tonight. And there she is after the huge knockout here tonight. What a moment for this fighter. You can't help but feel good for her here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 35 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout, Holly the Preacher's Butler Holm.
Well, you see the raw emotions and the happiness out of her in her corner. What a result here tonight as she gets it done by knockout.
I mean, she could not have imagined that it would go this well. I know she said it would happen, but when it does, I mean, it's joy. It's joy like nothing you've ever felt before. You don't expect it.
All right, so here we go with round one. She is a striker. Her counterpart is a grappler. And I know as much as the grappler tends to fall in love with the hands of late, you got to think she's going to try to get this fight to the ground.
If she falls in love with the hands too much, she will end up laying flat on her back, looking up at the lights. She has to get this match to the floor as fast as she can. If she does not, if she tries to stand, if she tries to get cute, she will get her clock run and she will get knocked out.
Man, she might punch harder than you. Nice connection there.
I don't know about that, John, but she is a fast-acting striker. You gotta check these low leg kicks.
Now going upstairs with the left hook. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Oh, man, I'm no strike counter, but that head kick absolutely landed.
That kick got from the floor to her opponent's head before her opponent could react.
Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue.
Oh, what a punch.
Nice jab by her there, and another one for good measure. So before her opponent can reset, she doubles up on the jab.
She does a fantastic job of popping that jab twice behind her. Now she's finding so much success that she's landing double jabs.
Well, that left hand has been there for her tonight, not on that attack. Glancing right hand lands upstairs. So just over 20 total strikes for Holly Holm. Oh, man, how about her hooks tonight? Landed several already in the round, and there was another one for good measure.
Another one. What a fantastic hook landing. Great job mixing up the target.
Takedown defense holds up. Oh. Shot by her right off the top. Her opponent in a world of trouble now.
Her opponent in a world of trouble. She landed that punch in the exact spot that she needed to.
Well, the right hand has been there for her tonight at times. Not that time.
That landed clean.
Nice job by her there to block those shots when you first go to a boxing class. All right, so she finally gets the takedown. It wasn't for any lack of effort earlier on, but cleaned up the technique a little bit, and now we'll see what she can do.
She cleaned it up. She really did take her time back. She took a step back. She evaluated what's my best course of action. Figured
Vieta's trying for a Kimura here. Guard lands the right hand. 10 seconds to go in the round. Let's take a look back at some of the action from that previous round. DC Chief among it, the big knockdown courtesy of that punch.
A big knockdown off of that punch. She was flowing, letting everything go. And as she sat down on that strike, that put her opponent down. It looked like the fight was over, but we do go forward.
You ready to fight? Ready. Good.
Liver kick.
That shot blocked by Holly Holm. All right, well, she's landed those hooks at a high clip here tonight. Actually, some fans are starting to call her Mrs. Lineker. I think it's a pretty good nickname.
Oh, it's a great nickname because they fight in the same style. She's very heavy-footed because she wants to get everything into that left hook, right hook.
power. She's walking out.
She's hurt very bad. She's escaped. She has to get moving. If she stays in front of her opponent, she's going to take one more. That's going to end the night.
Whoa!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Quick entry to get in on a single.
That was a great single.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. Oh, nice job by her there. You see how strong she is. Her opponent's trying to control posture, unable to do so.
Now she can get to work and put the money in the bank with that ground and pound.
Money in the bank. So we call on the numbers here, DC. 39 total strikes.
She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Trying to stay in this fight. Well, she was a little bit hesitant in... Oh, look at that double leg takedown by her there. She's as good with that takedown attempt as any fighter, I would think, in this division.
As good as anybody across any division, across any gender in mixed martial arts. It's a confidence that she has when it comes to that specific takedown attempt.
Lands a big elbow there. Well, she whiffs on the straight right hand. Vieta's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling.
The record is on repeat. Wash and rinse over and over again. It's takedown after takedown.
She lands a kick there. She might be the best kicker in this division.
She may just be the best kicker in this entire division. She does a great job of using that as a way to dominate a fight.
See, there it is. She switched.
Well, she's had a lot of moments in the fight. All night. She did not miss that.
She's been looking for it, and she finally got it. And now she's going to see if she can close the night.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
That one was thrown to end the fight.
Land to end the fight for her here tonight. Just the way she drew it up, she had her focus on the knockout, and that's exactly the way this fight ends. I'm not even sure the opponent saw the shot coming. They oftentimes say it's the shot you don't see coming that spells your fate, and that certainly spelled her fate here tonight. And there she is after the massive knockout. That is one they will be talking about for quite some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 24 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout, Holly the Preacher's Daughter, Holmes.
Well, there she is, and you can be sure there's going to be a long line at the after party tonight after what she was able to accomplish tonight.
I mean, she will be as popular tonight as she's ever been, because no one forgets a knockout like this. It'll be on TV.
All right, so here we go, one of the better strikers in this division. Division, she is facing one of the better grapplers this division has ever seen. Pretty straightforward as to what you expect both of these fighters to do here.
I expect to see.
Combinations here. Oh, straight right. Oh!
You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
So both girls landing right out of the chute. Scuffs the takedown. No problem. And there comes the separation now.
Nice.
Back in the clinch now.
Nice diversity in the attack. Huge elbow lands in the clinch.
Oh, how about that reversal power there, champ?
That is a fantastic transition by this young lady. What a job.
Back to the feet now.
She's got her back. Big lift coming.
Big knee lands there.
That one landed clean.
Able to check that kick as well.
What a big time takedown.
Hey, there it is, her first takedown of the fight. She told us in our fighter meeting Thursday, at some point I will take her down. She didn't expect it to take this long, but here it is.
She really had to work to get this first takedown, and she never gave up on herself. Continued to press, continued to shoot, continued to level change. Now she finally has secured her first takedown. Punch over the top. Another clinch position. You take more of these leg kicks, you will not.
Yes, she's thrown tonight. Her opponent's a
beautiful placement.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. All right, so again, the fighters clinch here. Kind of had an inkling we'd find ourselves back in this situation.
Absolutely. Both of these fighters love fighting chest to chest. The uglier the fight, the better.
All 25 total strikes for Holly Holm. And a nice job at least staying upright on that. Holm gets caught with that punch.
I mean, that right hand landed square. Big leg kick lands. If your opponent has you in the clinch, pulling down on your head, landing punch after punch, you have got to clear that collar tie, reach back inside, and try to find space.
And she's back up again, so the takedowns have been there. So have the get-ups. So she's making her way back to the stool, kind of shaking her head, thought maybe that knockdown would have produced a finish. Not so much.
She's a little discouraged right now because she thought the fight was over. But if you know her, if you spent...
She landed a kick there, DC. That was well done.
Well done.
Shot by her there. I'm not sure her opponent knows where she is. She's in the octagon.
She can't possibly know where she is right now after taking such a massive head kick. Beautiful body kick. Left change, your leg, finish the takedown. Great job.
Holm gets up and is back on her feet. Very nice.
Nice punch lands over the top.
Oh, swing and a miss. How about the slip by her there?
What a great job of moving her head right at the right time.
Well, she's got a good jab. Missed with it there. So we call on the numbers here. These are unofficial. The 42 total strikes have connected for Holly Holm. And landing with 68% accuracy against Ketlin Vieira. Just over 3 minutes to go. Now, oh, and a quick entry.
Great single entry. Rotates to high crotch. Taking for one.
How good is her movement here on the ground? Right shades of Ray Vieira's looking for that arm triangle now. Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground.
Ooh, beautiful connection by her on that punch.
She's so fast. And
huge right hand! Back to the feet! The eight is in half guard now. Well, that'll quiet the storm. Shot blocked by Holm. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitancy whatsoever here in round two. She has clearly found her rhythm and range. Take off. Beautiful scramble by her there to avoid the takedown and get this fight back to the feet. 20 seconds left. Oh, and she's back up again. And that's the end of round number two. All right, so there is the horn, so we will see another round. You thought maybe with that knockdown that that could have been the end.
You thought it was over. People don't usually get up from those types of strikes. She took that big punch, continued to plod forward. But if she does not move her head, her night will be over very quickly.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. She blocked the punch. Two off the top, her offensive wrestling was off the charts. She gets another takedown there. Now we'll see what she can do.
Now she looks to try and control her opponent because she's gotten a ton of takedowns, and it's awesome to see. But at some point, she needs to get some ground control if she truly wants to wear down her opponent.
Seminal blow of this fight thus far.
Yeah, man, she landed a massive hook, and it has her opponent hurt bad.
She just continues to land a high volume of strikes here, really just like she did in the previous round.
She is such a diverse strike.
Quick entry here.
Nice single leg entry. Rotates ahead outside to a high crotch.
When you get in a bad spot on the ground and you want to reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing position. Unreal to see.
So 57 total strikes have landed.
What you're going to see with this young lady, is she going to finish the fight?
She missed with that jab. We have crossed the midpoint of this fight.
Shot a double leg.
Oh, massive slam. That'll change the complexion of this one. Nice job by her there to reverse the position out of her.
She was in trouble. Now she is the one handing out the punishment. Great change of position. Oh.
Not sure she could have drawn it up much better. Just a beautiful strike to end the fight for her opponent, who candidly may not have even seen that flush shot coming. So this is exactly the way she drew it up. She told us during fight week that she had to find a way to finish this fight to send a message to the rest of this division. Message sent. Well, there she is. Man, did she have it going here tonight as she gets the huge win by knockout, near perfect execution, and that could be one of the better knockouts of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop this contest at 3 minutes, 18 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout, Holly the Preacher's Daughter.
There she is. This arena belongs to her here tonight. Hard-pressed to find a knockout in the women's game as stunning as that.
I mean, she has so much confidence in her hand that she's willing to stand in front of her opponent and take one to give one. And when she gave one, it shut the opponent's lights out. Great job finding that kill shot.
For a goon, why not? Career killers care about who they love. Bricks and 94 in a split. You my plug, respect that. How many you really know Mexicans? None of the Draco in the crowd, pedestrian. And look at you, ain't really killers. Catch your body, tip to get you. You crying out in your feelings. You with double chin, kill them. Kill making them type of statements. Oh, like, damn, you just on the gram. Exaggeration, but
it is a women's bantamweight matchup between Holly Holm and Amanda Nunes. Martial arts superstars on both sides, Amanda Nunes versus Holly Holm. And despite Nunes beating Cyborg to win the featherweight title, she still believes she does have it. So Amanda Nunes getting off here again as usual. Really as well-rounded a fighter as we have in the men's or the women's game here in 2020.
Yeah, regardless of gender, right? Regardless of gender, Amanda Nunes stands amongst the best in pound for pound in the entire UFC. Nice strike.
They continue to exchange. Holm going for the head kick here, but no setup, and as such, she
was... What a big-time takedown.
Oh, well played there as she gets back to her feet. Now connects with a right. Nunes' strike there is blocked. Nice job by the defense.
Oh, big head kick lands.
Circling to her right. Ah, she's unable to connect with the left hook. All right, so once again, the fighters engage in the clinch. We'll see who will have the upper hand here, champ.
There are so many options to dictate and control this exact position. Who is going to take advantage of it? Nice entry, direct entry. Nice kick.
Oh, nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
She has to recognize that her opponent will start trying to squirrel away now, but look for her big ground pound.
Wow, what a kick. Huge kick lands. So just over 20 total strikes have connected for Holly Holm. Well, she has really shored some things up defensively here as she blocks another set of shots there.
She said it was going to be a focus, get better defensively, and tonight she's showing that the work has been done.
Nunes gets caught with that punch. All right, there's the clapper. 10 seconds to go. Beautiful technique on the straight right hand. All right, so we now look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. A lot of good highlights on both sides.
I mean, a lot of good highlights from both competitors. They both should be very proud of what they accomplished.
Nice workout there.
And here we go with our second round. Holly Holm.
You ready?
And the lioness, Amanda Nunes. Whiffs on the straight right hand. Well, she's landed some good shots, but kind of point fighting a little bit, right? Nothing in terms of combinations.
And that's the problem. When you start point fighting and your jab is landing, if your opponent's landing more dominant strikes, you run the risk of the judge scoring for them.
Right.
Get in there, stick your nose in the fight. Don't be afraid to get a little bit dirty. Nice straight punch.
Oh, massive slam. That'll change the complexion of this one. Well, there are few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
26 total strikes for Holly Holm. Well, not the most efficient effort, landing with 33% accuracy against Amanda Nunes. How good a job does she do defensively to protect that head, raise the guard? A lot of good things.
Yep, hands up, chin down. She's got a perfect position for defensive boxing.
Just misses with a left hook there. Well, she was a little bit hesitant in round one, but she has certainly picked up the pace here in this second round. It took her a while to...
Nice takedown land.
Holm gets back up again.
Good punch.
Just a slip there.
Oh! You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Oh! Just out of range with the big right hand.
Beautiful leg kick thrown.
She's wobbling now.
She's hurt very bad. She's on skates. She has to get moving. If she stays in front of her opponent, she's gonna take one more. That's gonna end the night.
She gets back up here, but she is on wobbly legs. Oh, big knee there. And a nice job at least staying upright on that.
Punch over the top.
So she's making her way back to the stool, kind of shaking her head, thought maybe that knockdown would have produced a finish. Not so much.
She's a little discouraged right now because she thought the fight was over. But if you know her, if you spent any time with her, you understand that she's a smart fighter, and she will get right back to doing what she needs to do to win this fight.
You ready? You ready?
Third round underway. Oh, nice shot to the body, connects for her there. Somewhat surprising, we didn't see a lot of body work from her earlier in the fight, but she is getting after it now.
Big kick.
Oh.
That's a nice strike.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying higher right over the top. Her opponent in a world of trouble now.
Her opponent in a world of trouble. She landed that punch in the exact spot that she needed to. Way to hide that leg kick.
Big knee lands there. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Fighters back to their feet here. Straight right hand, but she misses. Just over 3 minutes to go now. Trying to hammer. That lead leg. Well, the numbers continue to pile up here. 56 total strikes have already.
Oh! Huge right hand!
She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish the fight. Oh! Oh!
Oh!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Now comes in and secures the takedown. Back to the feet. Under 2 minutes to go. Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed without. High-level MMA defense there, able to avoid the punch. Nice job by Holly Holm. Oh, she landed a huge knee to the head. Oh, straight right. Under a minute now to go.
Look at the turners in that kick.
Holly Holm's torso, specifically that right side, has absorbed a lot of damage. tonight. And here comes the purple, the black, and blue. A definite bruise starting to form on that right side. Oh, nice job to get the takedown late in the round. Certainly not resting on her laurels here as we wind it down in this one.
She's a grinder. She's going to take it out at the beginning of the round, middle, and the end. You have to know that you will be constantly under attack from this wrestle-heavy approach.
Well, a punch like that would have...
Big punch lands through the middle.
She blocked the punch. Not there. Holm gets tattooed by that straight punch. Oh!
Can never know what you're gonna see with this young lady. Is she gonna finish the fight?
Knee to the body. Now she's got the Muay Thai plump. Trying to establish that jab once again. Beautiful straight punch, and now her opponent's firmly on the ropes.
But she can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish. First striker, that big strike landed, and it looks like she's gonna finish this fight. Nice double leg shot.
Oh, how about the slam there? That one cannot feel good. Half guard position for her here, and if you're the bottom fighter, this is truly a case of pick your poison.
Yeah, you gotta pick your poison. And if you're gate that bottom leg, you cannot allow your opponent, you cannot allow her to sit on your leg and just throw big damaging strikes. You've got to make sure you're on an elbow control, an underhook, and getting back to your feet.
Oh!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish. Another clinch position. Look at that great work to the body for the clinch.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. Final minute to go here in round four. Gets up again here, but hurting.
Big body kick land.
As she misses with the left punch. Oh!
Jeez!
Take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
We now go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 27 seconds of round number 4, declaring the winner by knockout, Holly the Preacher's Buckout Holm!
Well, you see the raw emotions and the happiness out of her in her corner. What a result here tonight as she gets it done by knockout.
I mean, she could not have imagined that it would go this well. I know she said it would happen. But when it does, I mean, it's joy. It's joy like nothing you've ever felt before. You don't expect it.
told you so. Why you gotta be so emotional? Yeah, 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 I told you so. Took too many, my overdose. Yeah, 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 I told you so. Why you gotta be so emotional? Yeah, back, 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 back. Can you back it up? Oh, you say no me and you wonder why I act up. Brothers got my back and they stay hitting like a Mack truck. Hit them on the celly if I really need the backup. Whip, 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 yeah, whip it up. Sip, 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 sip. I'm a sippy cup. Drip, 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 drip. Then I mix it up. Yeah. Hey, yeah, I mix it up. Yeah, yeah, I told you so. Took too many, my overdose. Yeah, 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 I told you so. Why you gotta be so emotional? Yeah,
oh, no.
The kid did it again. Yo, shows be looking little and shit. Oh boy, they caught me sinning again. Oh boy, they caught me sinning again. Yeah.
It is a women's bantamweight matchup between Holly Holm and Raquel Pennington. Well, I'm not sure if she's a third degree or a fourth degree Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. All I know is that you are in imminent danger every time she closes the distance.
Oh, the belt color hasn't changed, John, but they are just adding stripe after stripe after stripe. She's got so many stripes on her Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt that it's unbelievable. And because of that ability to do Jiu-Jitsu at such a high level, it's almost like you're going into biology class whenever you go on the ground with her. Because as you're thinking, if I do step one to get to step two, she's already on step five.
Right.
She's working on the finish before you even understand that you're in danger. The quick strike ability in the jiu-jitsu is something not many people possess.
I cheated to pass my biology final in college. I wish there was a way to cheat in jiu-jitsu, but she doesn't need to. Big spot for her here tonight. All right, here she is, and still one of the best bantamweights or featherweights on this UFC roster, Holly Holm. She has had Mike Winklejohn.
You ready?
Well, for all the places we go in the world, few can hold up to this one. Good evening from T-Mobile Arena here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Opened April of 2016. UFC went there for the first time at UFC 200, and they've been bringing big shows seemingly every other month ever since.
They call Vegas the fight capital of the world. And if you're talking about a home base for the UFC, you're talking about T-Mobile Arena, home to some of the biggest UFC events ever. UFC 200, Conor McGregor versus Khabib Nurmagomedov. Off. This place has been the home of some of the biggest UFC fights in history. Tonight, you get to take the same walk to that octagon to try to make your mark on the sport. She gets to her spot, the tie clinch, and then she starts to let the knees fly.
And she lands a punch there. We'll see if she... Double leg here, taken down by Penny. Holm gets back up again. All right, so once again, the fighters engage in the clinch. We'll see who will have the upper hand here, champ.
There are so many options to dictate and control this exact position. Who is going to take advantage of it?
Back and forth we go. DC, for my money, she's really timing her shots pretty well here tonight.
Her timing, accuracy, and also the activity level is great tonight.
Man, how good is her offensive wrestling? I'm not sure if she's putting on a show because the Olympian's calling her fight tonight, but every time, essentially, she has gone to the takedown, it's been there.
Yeah, she's done a fantastic job of entering into the takedown over and over again, getting her opponent to raise her hands with strikes, dropping down on the legs, getting great angles, and securing her finishes. It's really good to see a game plan that people set out in front of them get accomplished.
So we pull up the numbers here. Oh, she goes high, and she did not miss there. This could be the end.
I mean, she hurt her so bad with that big head kick.
Well, the Muay Thai reps paying off tonight. Beautiful set of knees by her, though.
She said her opponent will present knee opportunities. To this point, she looks like a genius.
Wow, she just continues to execute on these takedown attempts. She hasn't always been able to keep her down, but she seems to be able to take her down at will.
And she has cardio to continue doing this for 15 minutes. It's not going to stop. It is going to be on her opponent to change the way that this fight is going. If she doesn't, she's going to continue to get taken down over and over again.
Oh, nice job to get the takedown late in the round. Certainly not resting on her laurels here as we wind it down in this round.
She's a grinder. She's going to take it down at the beginning of the round, middle, and the end. You have to know that you will be constantly under attack from this wrestle hit.
You ready? You ready? Fight!
She lands another head kick upstairs. That's what my grandmother says. Goodness gracious.
Over and over. She is landing that head kick like grandma used to say. Goodness gracious. John, I'd like to meet your grandmother. She sounded like a sweet woman.
Holm gets hit with a kick. And there comes the separation now. Both fighters get up now.
Nice head kick.
And that one was heavy. Beautiful spinning attack there.
That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep. Ooh. Oh, Pennington's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think. Oh!
You can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
50 total strikes and counting that have landed for Raquel Pennington. And unofficially landing with 51% accuracy against Holly Holm. Stuffs the takedown shot there. How good is her takedown D? All right, so not unlike we saw in round one, she's really starting to find a home for that hook here in round two. She's setting it up beautifully and... Oh! Oh! She's thrown tonight! The opponent's hook.
Beautiful placement on that hook. What a great shot!
Oh, she's trying to connect on the overhand left. Not there.
Ooh, big shot lands.
Oh! Hard shots landing on both sides here. All right, so the fighters are in the clinch again, DC. I get tired just watching these situations.
It's a good one. You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady.
That is unbelievable, John. Well, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
All right, here's Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliante has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 56 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout, Holly the Preacher's Daughter, Holm.
Well, you see the raw emotions and the happiness out of her in her corner. What a result here tonight as she gets it done by knockout.
I mean, she could not have imagined that it would go this well. I know she said it would happen, but when it does, I mean, it's joy. It's joy like nothing you've ever felt before. You don't expect it.
And we are underway.
What a punch.
Pennington gets tagged by the head kick there. Not sure how many more of those she can absorb if she wants to stay in this fight. Oh, she blocks the punch.
Nice body kick right on the elbow.
The dome, shades of Valentina Shevchenko against Jessica Eye. I'm not sure how many more head kicks her opponent can take here.
She cannot take many more of these head kicks. The wind level change, your leg, finish the takedown. Great job.
Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground. Great punch landed with so much power.
So again, they will clinch here. Well, eventually she will turn this defense into offense, but she seems to see these strikes coming from a mile away.
She sees them a mile away, and the hands are exactly where they're supposed to be, right on the tip.
Oh, you can feel the breeze there. Swing and a miss by hand. Finally, she gets the takedown. She stayed committed. At some point, she knew she was going to be able to get this fight in her wheelhouse on the canvas. Now let's see what she can do with it. Well, the damage starting to add up, bleeding from her cheek now.
Oh, big punch land. That was lightning fast, that right in.
Well, we told you off the top her offensive wrestling was off the charts. She gets another takedown there. Now we'll see what she can do.
Now she looks to try and control her opponent because she's gotten a ton of takedowns, and it's awesome to see. But at some point, she needs to get some ground control if she truly wants to wear down her opponent.
So just over 20 total strikes have connected for Holly Holm.
Big liver kick lands under the elbow.
Pennington gets caught with that punch. Right on the button. Oh, did she get tagged by that combination there? And unless they're going to give her headgear between rounds, she better start raising that goal.
She's got to start doing something, but it's a testament to her opponent. Throwing so many strikes, she's being so accurate with everything that she's throwing.
Oh, Pennington's looking for that arm. Triangle now. All right, a lot of tremendous striking action in that last round, DC. I know you don't have a telestrator, but take us through the replay.
I mean, I would love to have my telestrator right now. That was a great display of high-level mixed martial arts striking. Both combatants stood toe-to-toe and let it all hang out.
All right, DC, second round is getting underway. Round one, not the round of the year necessarily, but some good in there.
And it's not always going to be. You have two very talented fighters. Sometimes it's very even. That's what we saw in round number one. Big kick lands.
Pennington's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Sure, her opponent knows where she is. She's in the octagon.
She can't possibly know where she is right now after taking such a massive head kick. It's such a fast leg kick. She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish the fight.
And she connects with a punch there, champ.
She's so accurate. She's so good at timing all of her strikes.
All right, so we got a little bit of separation now, but watch out for the setup. You got to think she's going to shoot for another takedown.
She's going to shoot for another takedown, and it may not look pretty. It may be her taking a shot halfway up.
As we call on the numbers here, 47 total strikes.
Man, that was a great single.
All right, so there she goes, taking the fight to the ground yet again. She looked you right in your eye at our fighter meeting on Thursday. She said, I'm going to be able to... Pennington's looking for that arm triangle. Working hard, posting, and getting back up. Again, they will clinch. We'll see how it goes.
Oh! It's off! Oh! Woo!
Yeah, that was just a beautiful shot by her there to end the fight. I'm not sure she could have drawn it up any better than it played out here tonight. She lands the seminal blow there midway through the round. I'm not even sure her opponent saw it. So, big knockout win for her here tonight. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
All right, the official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called the stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 28 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout.